Happy New Year to all of you, and welcome to The Boss Rules the World. I'm the boss, and I rule. Sorry about being late with this episode, but we've been so busy here around New Hoonet Central this past weekend. Unfortunately, we did finish our Christmas shopping, and we did get the tree all decorated just in time.
Clumsy ox.
We were going to try to get laundry done during the big storm right before Christmas Eve. That was until I stepped out the door and came back in like Batman, walking like he did just when he entered the Mr. Freeze's cold zone.
You fool. You fool. I warned you against sudden changes in temperature. The air's freezing your lungs, yeah? Cold, frigid, frosty air, freezing your lungs solid like icicles. Now you know how I feel when the air is warm and I cannot breathe like you cannot now. You are freezing, yeah? If I choose, I can make you freeze to death. But not yet. Not yet. You must not die too easy.
Instead, we spent the weekend keeping snug in nice warm flannels and winter blankets, watching tons of crap on our DVR and streaming services. In fact, I'm jonesing for a cup of hot cocoa and marshmallows like my life depended on it. Meanwhile, you can check out our fantastic Christmas tree with all of our new residents. We think you'll like this.
TV. I'm friends with Fred, who yells out yabba dabba dabba doo. Who's a buddy Barney too? And Scooby-Dooby, where are you? I love that mumbling bear. I laugh at him until I hurt. And when it's banana splits, you don't eat them for dessert.
Gristle Hound is not a stranger. He saves lands he went in danger.
Yogi Bear outsparks the ranger. All in my TV. Those happy friends who live in my TV. Two friends with funny faces, Jinx sent them their Reese chases.
And he'll love Wendy Racer,
live in my TV. I'm friends with Fred who yells out,
Yabba Dabba Dabber Doo.
Who's a buddy Barney too?
Scooby Dooby, where are you?
I love that mumbling bear, I laugh at him until I hurt.
And when it's banana splits, you don't eat them for dessert. Smarts at Ranger, all in my TV. Them happy friends who live in my TV. Yakka dakka dakka doo doo.
They live in my TV.
And when he eats banana sweets, you don't eat them for dessert.
All in my TV, the happy friends who live in my TV.
I'm not scared.
So let's go into my picks of the weekend, and maybe you'll find something worthwhile to spend the rest of the holidays watching. You might even thank me for it later. First off, in case you haven't seen it yet, the Doctor Who centenary special, The Power of the Doctor. Not only is it Chris Chibnall's finest work on his time on Doctor Who, it's a grand story involving multiple companions, past and present, ties up Jodie Whittaker's era with not a few tears shed, an ending that just knocked it out of the ballpark. And you'll love who showed up for the group therapy session. You can still find it on AMC Plus or the BBC America streaming services, and it will be released this spring on Blu-ray and DVD. Originally, Tim Burton was to be the director of the first Addams Family movie. Unfortunately, his commitment to Batman Returns prevented him from assuming the mantle, and the project was turned over to Barry Sonnenfeld. Now, after more than 30 years later, Tim has another shot at Charles Addams' characters with Netflix's Wednesday series as producer and director of the first two episodes. Taking place as Wednesday Addams turns 16, the poster girl for goth has been expelled from her 8th public high school for her vengeful ways, and Morticia and Gomez send her to Nevermore Academy in Vermont, whose student body is made up of misfits, such as vampires, werewolves, ghouls, various mythological creatures, but also has room for the odd beekeeper, psychic, and telekinetic. As Wednesday plots her escape from the school, she becomes involved in a mystery that could only shut down the school, but also reveal her father as a murderer. I say someone called Mystery Incorporated. But it's a delightful show, full of great twists and turns, and Jenna Ortega could be vying for an Emmy next year. Her dance to the Cramps' The Goo Goo Muck is a highlight. Willow is back! Yes, Warwick Davis and his popular Nelwyn sorcerer has returned in a new series set nearly 20 years after the cult classic movie, with director Ron Howard as executive producer. Willow Oofgood has once again been called upon by Queen Sorcha, along with her willful daughter Princess Kit, her bodyguard and lover Jade, and other brave souls to bring an end to the Dread Gales and the Withered Crone who plot the supernatural conquest of the world. Warwick is in fine form and gets some of the funniest lines in the series. There are also a lot of dramatic twists and scary moments that aren't drowned out by unnecessary special effects. Some of the contemporary song choices that appear mostly during the closing credits can be a bit off-putting for diehard fans, a new cover of Black Hole Sun coming to mind, but it's well worth your time and much more complex than what you'd expect. Now that's on Disney+. Over on Paramount's Showtime add-on, you can see the excellent vampire series Let the Right One In, inspired by the original Swedish and American adaptation of John Lindquist's novel. While not a direct adaptation of the novel, it explores and expands on the themes of isolation, peer pressure, bullying, and love of family. Chef Mark Kane and his partner Kevin are on the verge of opening a new high-end gourmet restaurant in New York City with the support of his wife Elizabeth and 12-year-old daughter Eleanor. Then tragedy strikes. Eleanor is attacked and nearly killed by a creature in their own backyard. And though she survived, she has been turned into a vampire. While Mark, Kevin, and Elizabeth tried to use their own blood to sate her needs, it's not enough, leading Mark to stalk and prey on criminal deviants, with only a limited time to deliver the blood to Eleanor before it goes bad. His tragic failure on night one leads to a decision that puts he and Eleanor on the run for the next 10 years. But the possibility of a cure lures the Canes back to New York, where they find an apartment that may keep Eleanor safe. But they soon meet next-door neighbor's police detective Naomi Cole and her 11-year-old son Isaiah. Complications arise when Naomi is assigned to investigate a rash of mysterious, bloody deaths in the city. A bigger mess occurs when Isaiah and Eleanor meet each other and become good friends. Meanwhile, the daughter of a dying scientist who has been searching for a cure for her vampiric brother is given the keys to the car and continues her father's bizarre research. Is Ellie on the brink of becoming a normal human again, or is she about to become a danger to everyone around her? The 10-episode series has already been renewed, and it leaves us on a thrilling cliffhanger that guarantees that I'll be back. Also recommended is Sylvester Stallone's Tulsa King, created and co-written by Yellowstone mastermind Taylor Sheridan. Stallone plays Dwight the General Manfredi, a mob capo who has just returned from a 25-year stretch in prison and wants to pick up where he left off in New York. Unfortunately, the other capos have absorbed all of Dwight's assignments, so he's shipped off to Tulsa, Oklahoma, which is practically an open field. Dwight loses no time in establishing himself with a local bar and a hemp shop as new sources of income. Things seem to be working out to begin with relatively little violence, but soon old rivalries begin to resurface, as well as competition from a drug-dealing biker gang. And soon Dwight finds himself falling back on his own ways in a fight for survival. You can't help but root for Stallone, even as he's literally stomping out his enemies. And like Taylor Sheridan's Yellowstone series, this one has me totally hooked. Season streamings, everyone! Well, it looks like Old Man 2022 is ready to hit the trail, and 2023 is crawling our way like a whiny, colicky baby. Before we go, I want to bestow blessings on all of our viewers and friends and family. I especially want to bless my wife, Dina, for putting up with my craziness for what will be 40 years in 2023. So we're leaving you off with our alma mater, All I Want for Christmas Is Who. Have a wonderful holiday. Go easy on the eggnog. And we'll see you next year. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Happy New Year to you in jail.
Get a lot for Christmas, nothing like I really need. Didn't care for Call the Midwife, Benny Hill or Peel and Steed. Sorry, Diana. When I hear that blue box call just before the silence falls, Santa, please come through. 'Cause all I want for Christmas is who? To face the evil Daleks. Is laughing, but we'll show him a thing or two. So when I hear that blue box call, when Autons wreck the shopping mall, well, Sandy, please come through. 'Cause all I want for Christmas is who? Monty Python, Baldy Towers, bring a smile right to my face. But when Pat Trout foils the bad guys, my heart just seems to skip a pace. Downton Abbey's way too soapy, EastEnders puts me to sleep. The Wednesday Devils are attacking, who sends them back into the deep? So he'll find me up all the night, squeezing my adipose real tight, until he's TARDIS blue. 'Cause all I'll be watching is who. From Eccleston to David Tennant to Matt Smith and beyond, they'll save the day before you can say, get your coat, Amelia Pond. With Capaldi ever grumping and temporal engine stumping, Sandy, can't you bring us who we really need? Bring the doctor here at lightning speed. All the box sets and the specials, that is all I'm asking for. How I'd love to have Jodie Whittaker on my Blu-ray shelf forevermore. And off into the stars we'd race, spanning all of time and space. A Christmas wish come true. 'Cause all I want for Christmas is who? 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 Yeah, who? All I want for Christmas is that crazy alien who's been throwing us for almost 60 years. Oh, yes! Alan Z! We interrupt this program for an incoming preview of next year's Doctor Who 60th Anniversary Special.
Sometimes I think there's something missing. Like I had something lovely. And it's gone.
show is just beginning.
Worldwide premiere.
Who are they?
Monsters.
I don't believe in destiny, but if destiny exists, then it is heading for Donna Noble.
Open fire!
If she ever remembers me, she will die.
You mean man? He's not there. You can't see him.
Halloween! Someone tell me what the hell is going on here?
Oh my God, that was Beep the Meep. Beep the Meep! And I think that was his race's greatest enemies, the Roth Warriors, from the Doctor Who magazine comics. Seriously, are we going there? Oh, no, this is too much. This is too much. Oh my God. Well, we'll find out. It's a long way in November. Gear up, guys. Things are going to get good. See ya.
Christmas Day.